Hello everyone, let us see our first problem on line integral. We have given an f vector which is x a x cap, y a y y and z a z cap. As we all know, these are the unit vector in the direction of x, y and z. In the earlier classes, we have seen they can also be represented by I cap, j cap and k cap. This is just another way of notation. There is one more way of notation which is x cap, y cap and z cap, like this. So there are multiple notations for these unit vectors, right? So don't get confused, these are the same things. Now we have to find the line integral of this f vector along the curve C, where C is the straight line from origin to the point P 1 2 3. So how do we do it? We know line integral of f vector along any curve C is defined as f dot dr vector over the limit of C, right? Isn't it? Now we have given f and we know r vector, which is position vector, is defined as x a x cap plus y a y cap plus z a z cap. So what will be dr on doing differentiation both side, differential element? It will be dx a x cap plus dy a y cap plus dz a z cap. Now what we have to do? We have to do f dot dr. We have to do dot product of f vector and dr vector. So it will be, now this ax dot ax will be 1 and ax, the dot product of ax with ay and az will be 0. So what we will get? We will get x dx. Then this y ay will be dot producted with the whole dr and only the term with the ay cap will be in the picture, rest will be 0. So it will be y dy and same for the next one, z dz, right? So this vector will be x dx plus y dy plus z dz. Now what are the limits for x? It is from origin. Origin has coordinate 0, 0, 0. And for y it will be 0 to 2. And for z it will be 0 to 3. Why? Because origin is a coordinate 0, 0, 0 and these are x, y, z coordinate of P. So it will be x square by 2, 0 to 1 plus y square by 2, 0 to 2 plus z square by 2, 0 to 3. It will be 1 by 2 plus 2 plus 9 by 2, right? So the answer will be 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. This is the answer of the given problem. Now let us see the next problem. This is same, similar to the earlier problem. The C, curve C is same, straight line from origin to P 1, 2, 3. Only the vector F is changed. Let us see why I have changed this vector F. So the line integral of F along C, it will be equal to f dot dr over the curve C. If we do according to the last problem, what we will get? We will get y dx plus z dy plus x dz, isn't it? So this is the step where we got stuck, because if we will put limit of x here, then we cannot integrate y here. We have to assume it constant and then the answer will be in the terms of x, y and z, but we want a definite value, right? So in such integration we need to replace these terms, like this y should be replaced by the function of x, this z should be function of y and this x should be function of z. So somehow we have to find an equation so that we can do these changes. So how do we get? Here I am introducing a concept of parametric equation of straight line. So the parametric equation of a straight line, if this is a straight line and have coordinate x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, then the parametric equation of a straight line is equal to x minus x1 upon x2 minus x1 is equal to y minus y1 upon y2 minus y1 is equal to z minus z1 upon z2 minus z1 is equal to lambda. keep remember this guys, this is the parametric equation of straight line. You must have read it somewhere. Even if you don't, just remember it, that this is the parametric equation of a straight line having the two endpoints are x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2. Now, for this case, for a given case, x1, y1, z1 are origin and x2, y2, z2 are point P, 1, 2, 3. So our equation will be x up minus 0 upon 1 minus 0 is equal to y minus 0 upon 2 minus 0 equal to z minus 0 upon 3 minus 0 equal to lambda. So what we get here, x equal to lambda, y is equal to 2 lambda and z equal to 3 lambda. These three equations we got here. Now this equation can be written as y. Since y is equal to 2 lambda and lambda is equal to x, so we can write it here 2x dx, right? And then z, since z is equal to 3 lambda and y is equal to 2 lambda, so z is equal to 3 and lambda is equal to y by 2, so 3y by 2 dy plus z, z x dz. Now I have to write x in terms of z, since z is equal to 3 lambda and lambda equal this, lambda equal to z by 3, so it means x is equal to z by 3, so it will be z by 3 dz, isn't it? Now we can put simply the limits of x, y and z. The x limits are from 0 to 1, y limits are from 0 to 2 and z limit are from 0 to 3. Easy integration, we can easily solve it. It will be x square, right, 0 to 1, it will be 3 upon 2 y square by 2, 0 to 2 plus 1 by 3 z square by 2, 0 to 3. Now it will be 1 plus 3 by 2 into 4 by 2 plus 1 by 3 into 9 by 2. It will be equal to 1 plus 3 plus 3 by 2. This is your answer. 4 plus 3 by 2, that is 4 to 8, 9, 10, 11, 11 by 2. Is the correct answer. Now let us see one more problem on line integral. In this, we have to find the line integration of f vector along curve C, where f vector is this given vector 8x square yz I cap plus 5z j cap minus 4xy k cap. And C, this curve is parametrized by r vector is equal to t I cap plus t square j cap plus t cube k cap. This is basically the problem of line integration based on parametrization. So we will solve it by using two methods. Let us see method one. We know r vector, which is a position vector, is equal to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. So on equating this r vector and this r vector, we can easily say x equal to t, y is equal to t square and z equal to t cube. Since t is varying from 0 to 1, right, here from here 0 to 1, it means x, y, z, all three will also vary from 0 to 1 according to their function, isn't it? So they will also vary from 0 to 1. Now, all we have to do is line integration of f vector along C. It will be equal to f dot dr, right? So it will be equal to 8x square yz dx plus 5z dy minus 4xy dz. As we have discussed in the earlier numericals, this we got, right? Now we have to change this y and z in terms of x, right? So what we will do, what we can do is 8x square and y. Since y is equal to t square and x equal to t, so y can be x square. Now z, z equal to t cube and x equal to t, so it will be x cube dx plus 5z. Now we have to write z in terms of y. So it will be equal to z equal to t cube, y is equal to t square. So it means z is equal to y to the power 3 by 2, isn't it? dy minus 4x. X equal to t, but in terms of z, it will be equal to t to the power 1, z to the power 1 by 3. This is z, z to the 1 by 3, and y, y is equal to z to the power 2 by 3, right, and dz. Now, If you can easily solve it, this will be 8, this is x square, x cube, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will be x 8 by 8 from 0 to 1, because x will have limit 0 to 1, y will have limit from 0 to 1, and z will also have limit from 0 to 1. This will be equal to 5, y to the power 3 by 2 plus 1, so it will 5 by 2 upon 5 by 2, again 0 to 1, minus 4, it will be equal to z 1 by 3 plus z 2 by 3. It will be equal to this part. This we can write as z 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3. So it will be equal to z to the power 1 only, right? So this will be equal to z square by 2, 0 to 1. It will be equal to 1 plus 2, 5, 5 cancel, 2 minus 2, isn't it? From here we will get only minus 2. So the answer will be 1. Now let us see method 2 to solve the same problem. For this method, we need to remember a formula for parametrization. Line integral of f vector along the parametrized curve C can be written as f, we have to write it in terms of r of t dot dr of t upon dt multiplied by dt over the curve C. This is the formula that we can use for such problem. Since the curve here C is parametrized by the variable t, so we can use this formula also, right? This formula is also easy. Let us see how we can do. We know r is equal to x a x cap plus y a y cap plus z a z cap. On comparing these two, what we got? X equal to t, y is equal to t square, and z equal to t cube, isn't it? So convert, write f in terms of t. So it will be equal to 8. X is equal to t. So x square will be t square. Y is equal to t square. And z equal to t cube, I cap. Plus 5z. Z is t cube, j cap. Minus 4x. X is equal to t. Y is equal to t square, k cap. So overall it will be equal to 8t to the power 7, I cap. Plus 5t cube, j cap. Minus 4t cube, k cap, right? Now, dr upon dt, we have given r this, so dr vector upon dt, it will be equal to I cap, we have to differentiate with respect to t. So what we got? I cap plus 2t j cap plus 3t square k cap. Now, what we have to do? We have to do dot product of this f vector, and this is the dot product, and drt upon dt. So what we will get, I'm writing here, this line integral will become integration. Now I cap will go with I cap only, so 8t7 plus 5t cube, and here we have 2t also, so it will multiply by it, then minus 4t cube, and here we have 3t square, right? And overall at the end we have 1 dt also, and the limit of t is 0 to 1. So it will be equal to 8t7 plus 5 to 10 t4 minus 4 3 12 t5 dt. On solving it, what we get? We will get t8 0 to 1 plus 10 t5 by 5 0 to 1 minus 12 t6 by 6 0 to 1. It will equal to 1 plus 2 minus 2, it will equal to 1, the same answer that we got earlier, right? So both method are easy. This method that I have boxed here is also has importance in many numericals, right? Here we have two methods to solve it. Use the method which is convenient to you. Now let us see one more problem of the line integral based on the parametrization. In this problem, we have given that this is the f vector minus y ax cap minus x ay cap, and we have to find its line integral over this curve C, which is start from 1, 0 and go to 0, 1, but not in the straight path, but in the curve path, right? Now, this is the problem here, because f vector is given in the Cartesian coordinate system, and the given curve C is something like in cylindrical coordinate system or in spherical coordinate system. So here There can be multiple methods to solve it, but what I use the parametric formula, right? Since this is the one section, one quadrant, or 1/4 of the circle, right? So let us write the parametric equation of circle. The parametric equation of circle have radius r and traversing in counterclockwise direction is defined as r of theta is equal to r cos theta ax cap plus sin theta ay cap. This is the parametric equation of any circle having radius r and traversing in counterclockwise direction, right? If it is traversing in clockwise direction, then replace theta by minus theta. Now, here theta will be from 0 to 2 pi. You can also draw this circle by varying the parameter of theta, right? Let us see here. Suppose this is ax cap and this is ay cap. Then when theta will be 0, the r theta vector, this curve will be equal to only r ax cap. So it will be here, isn't it? When theta will be 90 degree, then it will be here, right? So it is going in this way and having the same radius. Here also it will have radius r. Here also it will have radius r. And this way it will traverse counterclockwise. So this is the equation, parametric equation of circle having radius r and traversing in counterclockwise direction. Now let us move further. For our case, for given case, this is a section of the, this is sphere only, this circle only, okay, in the first quadrant, and we can observe that r is equal to 1 and theta is also varying from 0 to pi by 2 in counterclockwise direction. So our equation will be r theta, it will be equal to cos theta ax cap plus sin theta ay cap. Now our formula is line integral of f vector along any parametrized curve C is equal to f in terms of theta dot dr theta upon d theta, right? This time we are using theta in terms of t. Now first we have to write f in terms of theta. Okay, first let us do the differentiation of this dr theta upon d theta. It will be equal to minus sine theta ax cap plus cos theta ay cap. Now let us write f vector in terms of theta. It will be equal to, since f vector is equal to minus y ax cap and minus x ay, and we know that r vector is equal to x ax cap and y cap. So on equating this equation and this parametric equation, what we can observe, or on equating this equation r vector and this equation that we observe for our case, right? On equating these two equations, what we observe that x equal to cos theta and y is equal to sin theta. So y is equal to sin theta minus sin theta ax cap and x equal to cos theta minus cos theta ay cap. Now do the dot product. So what we get, f theta dot dr theta, on we have to do dot product of this and this. So what we will get, minus sine, it is sine square theta, then minus cos square theta, and then finally this d theta, right? We can also write it as minus cos square 2 theta d theta, and theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2 only. So the answer will be minus, this is not cos square, this is cos 2 theta only, right? This is the formula of cos 2 theta, that cos square theta minus sin square theta. So the answer will be minus of sin 2 theta upon 2, 0 to pi by 2. It will be equal to minus 1 by 2. Sin pi will be minus 1 and sin 0 will be 0. So answer is 1 by 2.